365 training with myself, Christy Williams, and Sean Farrell. Before we get started, we are going to talk about teams today. We're kind of transition this into more of like a teams workshop. So we want this to be really tailored to what you guys want to do and want to learn. So please, please, please ask questions. And I have a couple of you reached out prior, so I have those questions ready to go, and we'll make sure that Sean answers those for you today. Before we get started, I wanted to pick your interest, pick your brain, and see, you know, we're looking at how we can help you guys further, and we are looking at possibly adding a training tool to our toolkit that we can offer you guys, and there'll be a really minimal cost per user. It's AI and behavioral based, so it's not just go watch this video and be done with it. It's installed and built into your Office 365, so on office.com it would be there. And it's, as I said, it's behavioral based, so if you're a power user in Outlook, but your colleague doesn't really know much about Outlook, your two trainings are gonna be very different. And again, it's activity based, so what that means is you're not gonna go just watch a video. You're gonna log in and it's gonna say, go do this in Outlook, and once you complete it, it'll mark it as complete and move you on to the next one. So it's all customized. So if you guys see on your Zoom, there's a way to raise your hand. So I wanted to just see if anyone was interested, just raise your hand. We're not gonna talk about it now or call you out or anything. So if this is something your business would be interested in, I just wanna get a number and see if this is something. Okay, cool. I'm seeing a few hands raised. I'll keep an eye out for the next email, because when I send out the next recording, I will have more information about what this would look like for you guys. So awesome. Thank you guys for letting me know. I'm going to go ahead and lower everyone's hand. And then now I'm going to turn it over to Sean, who's going to go into some file sharing and some stuff in Teams today. So I'll stop sharing and let you share now, Sean.
Sure. And why I'm doing this, you guys, I would say we've been putting this into companies quite a bit. And the idea is that I believe a lot of what the market's going to start doing is moving from what I'll call end user support, meaning things aren't going to break as much as they used to. And we're going to start seeing things from more of a, how do we use or how do we experience the tools we're using? So these things are great. The AI, as we hear that term all the time, AI, it basically is just watching like how we're using Outlook, and it'll say, oh, you know, I noticed that person, instead of going down to the little calendar, then clicking meeting, maybe there's just a quicker way to click the meeting button in the top. So anyway, let me see if I can get going here. Christy, can you see my team screen?
Yes, I can see it now. So I know people were asking about, you know, uploading files and channels and sharing those files. So I know you do this every day, so I'll let you run with it, and then I'll chime in with some questions once you get going.
And we thought, for a lot of the new people who have joined us in recent weeks, you know, we've had quite the, you know, following, we thought we'd go back to the basics of Teams a little bit here. But again, please, Christy, keep track of this. We'll answer any questions. And if I have to jump between programs today, whether it's Outlook or Word or, you know, PowerPoint, you name it, just let us know what those questions are, and we'll try to do as best we can. This is not a demo. This is more of a, you know, just what it could look like, a day in the life of, you know, you working with Microsoft Teams. So I think we showed, you know, in the original, you know, slides, Microsoft Teams is part of your Office 365 platform. In a lot of cases, you know, it's actually something that if you guys are just using Teams as an organization, it's free right now, but it's part of Office 365 if you already have it. And most companies we're seeing these days do. But when I want to delineate between what Teams and Zoom and Slack and log me in and all these other products are, WebEx from Cisco, we deal with them all. But Teams, probably its closest competitor is going to be a product like Slack. And the idea is that when we take file systems, like servers that have been on-premise for years and they're aging out, or, you know, where we clicked to save a file in our C drive or G drive or F drive, whatever, Teams is the new way for doing document management. And it's a much more collaborative way, and I hope everybody's seeing that. So yes, it has the voice component if you want to use it as your phone system. It has the ability to do the conferencing component. And I think we announced last week that if you have Teams, any day now, you're going to be able to see the 9 people in your screen. And you're also going to be able to see things like breakout rooms where you can go out and have a sidebar conversation, which is such an interesting thing in the world of web conferencing right now, where everybody's in the conversation. If you want to get on a topic where you want to talk about something else, it's hard to do. So that's all getting announced. backgrounds have been put into place now, so you can get all the cool, you know, if you want to be in Hawaii today, you can. But that's all happening. So teams, let's just start with this. The left-hand side, if you just keep it really simple and high level in every company, you want to have things like, you know, you want to know as a company what's happening from an activity perspective. So we show these activities. This is kind of my feed on a daily basis. You know, anything that's happening across all my various teams inside of my organization, I'm seeing here. So one of our PMO managers yesterday is doing an onboarding of several customers. So obviously I want to know how that's going. You know, if I click into this, I'm going to be able to go into the onboarding status tracker and really see with the other team members who are part of this, which you see right here, you know, what's going on. And by the way, if I had a question about any of those things, whether it's to say Jacqueline in particular, I can go right into an instant message or a chat and be able to see, or even video call her, you know, what she's got going on. But second is obviously the chat function. You can see all the chats that have happened, you know, which is very common in businesses now, but again, fully integrated. But the third one really is where people are asking most questions about, which is really about teams and creating them and really trying to understand what the heck a team is versus, say, a channel and all of the above.
And I'm going to interrupt you there, Sean, too.
Yeah.
People were having some questions about groups, too. So maybe as you're talking through, like, the teams and channel hierarchy, you could mention how groups plays into that, too.
Yeah. Let me answer the question about groups right off the bat. Let me see, again, this is not a great live demo, but let me see if I can show you. So in Outlook, if you go into your email, you're going to start to notice that down the email chain, there are groups, if you see them right here. That group was something that I created in Teams, and then I'll show you how to do that in just a second. But that is, think about it as, you know, maybe my marketing team, maybe that's a group. Okay, so anytime I send an email to, say, sales and marketing, or frankly, I get an email from sales and marketing, it's going to come into Outlook. But groups are really good for sending sort of mass messages to a certain segment of the team. So you're going to see anybody who's in this group, it could be Tina, Danielle, Christy up there, you know, these things come through Outlook or can be created in Teams.
And what I love about these groups is if you notice on the Outlook screen, there's the following button. And so what that essentially means, so in the top right near all the images, the circle images, it says following. That means that any email that goes to that group alias is going to go into your inbox. But if there's groups that you're a part of that you don't necessarily need to, like, be alerted every time there's a new email, you can go in and just look. So, you know, like Sean has 99 plus unread on the senior leadership team. Well, he hasn't not read those because they go to his inbox. And so you just have to come down and clear them. So it's nice that you can choose to, like, be notified right away in your inbox and by following these, or if you don't follow them, you still have access to them in your Outlook, but you're not getting pinged every time there's an announcement. So it's a nice way to keep you organized and not overflow.
Yep. And again, for me, you know, for example, sales and marketing, I follow the group and I'm in the group, but really I just want to see what's happening within. And typically I don't follow this in Outlook as you're seeing right here. I follow it inside of Teams and that's where it comes into my activity. But again, that's the concept of really groups, and I hope that helps. So if you could think about segmenting out different parts of the organization, you know, that's one way to do it. So let's go back into teams. So I'll just start with the bottom. Everybody wants to understand really how to create a team, and I'll just go through this really quickly. You know, you're going to see that we already have lots and lots of teams created, okay? And some of the teams, if you're probably noticing, are going to be teams that can be inside and outside of our organization and managed solution. So my example would be, and this is a really good scenario, is we do a lot of projects with companies outside of our team. We can create it so our internal project manager, our engineers, and of course our customer can all be part of a team, and anything that's flowing through that, whether it's a Microsoft project document or a PowerPoint or say just a Word doc or an Excel file with a project plan, can be communicated down and sent in through that team. So anyway, it's a really unique way to communicate with people from the outside of the organization. So let's start with this. You notice down here, by the way, here's an existing Office 365 group, but let's say we want to build a team from scratch. We would click it here. Obviously, if we want to make it so anyone can essentially join the team, it's kind of like a LinkedIn group, so to speak. If you wanted to join something you wanted to follow, that's one way to do it. But if I want to keep it private and give certain people permission, I can do that. So I don't know, we'll call this Sean's Test at Home. You know, I can create this, and my spelling needs to be a bit better today. I can put a description of the team. That's all it takes to create a team. I see Christy Keating laugh, or Williams laughing at me in the background. But anyway, that's how
you have fun during this, right?
So that's how you do it. Now, if I want to add people to the team, you know, I just start typing in their email address and it'll auto-populate. It'll find people in our organization. If I want to, you know, create people from the outside, I can do that as well. And they're going to get, you know, these are the people in my group, they're going to get notification via email that they've been added to the team. But if you want to make them a member of the team or an owner where they can actually manipulate what's happening in this particular team, that's really up to you. But you know, in this case, I'll make them a member. I close it, and then ultimately, it's going to create a team right here. Welcome to the team. So I'm not, well, we'll take this team. Let's use this one for today. We have a new team here. If I want to add more people, I could do it here. Oh, Janelle must know we added her to the team. You're noticing that she's already chatting with me, and this is not scripted, I swear to you, everyone. So you're probably wondering what I'm doing. But anyway, so the first thing you got to see is kind of what's happening inside of a team. You have what I call, you know, if any of you guys are Facebook fans out there or users of what I'll call the waterfall type of information. This is where, you know, we have quick chats, and we do this internally all the time as an organization. And, you know, you can add emojis and all that other good stuff. You can add videos and, you know, all that good stuff. So this is a really unique way for companies to just quickly within a team have a chat.
My favorite obviously. Is the GIFs. We've created our own meme channel now within the organization because it just gets so out of hand.
And I, Christy, I would say this. I mean, for culture, it's been a really unique thing. Mm-hmm. We've done things like talent shows. We had one of our employees who did an old, if you remember that song, I'm So Happy or Happy by Pharrell or whatever yeah. it was. He did this great video out of Colorado and put it up in here. So just really cool for culture. We're learning a lot of things about people we didn't know.
Especially when we're all remote now. So
yes, it really works. You're going to notice other buttons down here like stream, which is the Microsoft product we showed last week where you can go right into it and post a stream or a video that you did. You're noticing over here, I can kick off a WebEx call or a Zoom call. It's just really a unique place to come in and do those chats and really get information out very quickly. But the bigger thing is really think about what we talked about, you know, in the initial stages of this was file sharing systems, okay? Today I'm showing you obviously a brand new team, so there's nothing in it. But what I do want to show you is what's possible inside of sort of the team that we've created, you know, Sean's team over here, and what we can do.
Sean, so, I have a question. Yeah. If you created a team that was an already existing team and you had files in SharePoint, those would show up here, right?
Sure. Yeah. If anybody uses SharePoint out there, I mean, I could go to this general tab, which is a demo team we have. All files that have been created in SharePoint and have been quote unquote mapped to the right team are really sitting on the back end of Microsoft Teams. So if anybody's wondering about what to do with SharePoint, Teams is now the front end for SharePoint in a lot of cases. We call it modern day SharePoint with Teams. So we're doing a lot of that for customers because this interface makes it 10 times easier. So I jumped over to this general demo tab because we actually do have some things in there, but you know, I thought I would start with the files. So imagine in each individual team, just like in your traditional file sharing, you know, platforms. And let me just give you my example. Here's what used to be our G Drive, okay? And it's got everything from, you know, our Active Directory teams to clients all the way down. So you can imagine or picture those as sort of teams. If I jump back over to Teams, and this team in particular, this general demo team, think about it as our maybe client folder. But you're going to see in here everything from, you know, PowerPoints that have been uploaded to OneNotes that we've talked about before that are in there. But a lot of people ask me, you know, how do I get documents in here? And there's many ways, but, you know, the simplest way is once you've created a team, just come into the upload tab. And I don't know, I wrote this recent message to the company about staying safe during these times and just feeling like, you know, our employees are safe working for us and, you know, keeping our clients safe. So you'll notice it just uploaded. It's in Teams. You can see what it's all about. You can see who last modified it, you know, when I did it, all of the above. So that's really a simple way to think about how you guys do document management.
And that's only going to show up in that one channel of the team, right? You can have different files in different channels.
Correct. Yeah, I could take this document and load it up into different, you know, say I wanted to put it into the senior leadership team or, you know, down in sales and marketing. Really up to me where I want to do it. Yeah, I could put it into Sean's test at home, which is down here. It's really up to you. And by the way, as we create teams over here on this left-hand column, you can actually have what's called pin teams, or teams that you ultimately leverage the most, okay, and that are most important to you. So say for me, it's, you know, finance and accounting as an example. But let's take this document. So we put it in here. You know, we always talk about this, you know, general tab and what it can actually do for us. From here, if I want to take this and say, rename the document, I want to, like we talked about earlier, as Christy said, open it in SharePoint, which is not really a need to do. Any of those things, I can do it. I can also just click on the thing and open it in what's going to be called, you know, I guess, embedded inside of Teams as a Word doc. But if I want to go a little bit further and I want to edit it, you know, say in Microsoft Word online or on premise, you know, essentially if I have Word on the desktop. And by the way, a lot of companies are asking me, do I need desktop versions of Word and Excel and all that? Simple answer is most companies have it. A lot of companies, you know, just want to be able to do it online. So it's really up to you. But as you'll see, you know, we've just opened up the document in Word. So pretty straightforward and pretty simple.
Sean, we had a good question come in. Someone asked about how they would save a file that they received via email to a folder inside Teams.
Yeah. So if you received a document, and I'm trying to see if, and remember, this is not a demo, so I want to be very careful here. But if you received a document, let's see, I'm trying to see if I can have one even earlier today. I probably do.
Matt,
go ahead.
I was going to say, Matt sent the, if you, Matt was at the top, I saw you could.
See Matt in there from Microsoft?
Yeah, he'd sent some PowerPoints over.
Okay, so let's find Matt real quick. Let's see, I saw it yesterday. Here we go. So here's an email from Microsoft that came in yesterday. It was some, you know, talking about a product that we do called Azure Active Directory. So you're going to notice, by the way, this document actually was shared down to us through the cloud-based version of PowerPoint. So it also means it's a shareable doc where we can go in there. You see down here where it says My SharePoint, where we can go in there and we can actually, you know, work and collaborate with Matt on the document. But if I want to, there's a few options here. I can, you know, open up the document obviously in PowerPoint, or I can take it, you know, right here and do the little drop down and do a save as, or I can even go up here and save this document to us, to my computer, or I can save it up inside of Teams, which, you know, I can go through this scenario real quick. And Christy, I mean, is there other ways that you do it?
So I have mine synced to my hard drive, most of the folders that I access regularly via OneDrive. So I would save it there and then it would just show up in Teams because that's all synced. Or sometimes if I will save it to my desktop and then upload it to Teams, which is just kind of another added step. Sometimes if I don't have that specific folder that I want it to go to synced, I'll put it to my desktop first and then go to Teams and upload it.
Yep. So here's, you know, here's an example of what Christy's talking about. If I want to go ahead and I just downloaded that document as you saw to the desktop. If I want to save it, I have to hit enable saving, and this is shared by Microsoft. I can do it from there once it's open up in PowerPoint. Oops, got a lot going on because we're trying to do this the right way. And I actually can save it to my site, which is connected to Teams, which is, like we said, the back end of SharePoint, or I can save it to OneDrive, which again is connected back to a particular team. So it's really up to you how you set up the saving function inside of, you know, I guess a document that comes through Outlook, but that has to point back to your Microsoft Teams.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So just to clarify, because he wrote in again, yeah, you can save it by downloading it to the desktop and saving it to Teams or syncing your folders, or as Sean just showed, I forgot that that was an option. You can just go in and save, and it has the SharePoint site right there for you to click on. So The beautiful thing about all these Microsoft products is how insanely integrated they are. So
And to somebody's really question, maybe this will help answer it too. If you want to be able to sync certain documents or certain file shares of multiple documents to say a OneDrive, or even if it's like a Dropbox or a Google Drive or one of those things, you can do it here as well. Mm-hmm. You just have to have that set up in Teams so that you know, those things are in essence syncing. So we talked
another
about
question come in the meantime related to the group. Someone was asking how they delete a group in Outlook. So I guess one would be how you get out of the group or how you just delete it.
Yeah, so, and again, I'm trying to navigate between screens here, but good question. So
you're doing a good job.
The one is you have to be the owner of the group, okay? So if I'm not, IT leadership, for example, which I'm not part of the group, or I am part of the group, I have to be able to be the owner. So whoever created the group has the option to delete it. Now, if in fact, you know, you're going to see over here kind of who's in this group, it looks like just myself. But if I took sales and marketing, which I believe Tina may have created or Christy created, only they have access to delete the group. They can do that from within Teams. They can do that from within Outlook. But those are really the two options. But they have to be the ones who work within the group. Well, and they can, I mean, most of the time we do it within Teams. But that's how groups get deleted, by the owner of the group. So let me roll across this really quick. So, you know, people ask the opposite question. If I start everything in Teams, that's where I come in every day and I'm looking at my activities and my chats, and which is kind of where I start my day. You know, what if I want to create something new, a new document? And here you're going to see I can even create, just like we did in the old days of the file sharing systems, a folder. But if I want to create a new, I don't know, Excel workbook or Excel spreadsheet, I can do it from here and quickly create it. Now, it's going to upload or going to start up inside of Microsoft Teams, okay? And people keep asking this great question, you know, can I do it or can I do it from my desktop? So if you're comfortable inside of Microsoft Teams and doing Outlook the way you see it here, which it just came up, you can do it that way. Or you could just click open in desktop app right up here at the top and you can resume editing on your desktop. And there it is down there sitting on your computer, which, you know, I'll have to toggle between screens again as it's opening down here. And I won't do that for you guys because it's going to take a minute. But that's another way to be able to get back to doing it from your desktop, okay? You're also going to see, once you've done these type of things, the ability to do things like, you know, start a conversation with somebody that the document is, in fact, shared with, okay? So if I'm sharing with Christy and we want to co-author this Excel doc, we can do that from within here as well. And again, if the document has been shared and Christy downloads it to her desktop, she's going to see it, and I don't know if I have by chance a document open on my computer. Let's see. Do we have any? I don't know. Yeah, so this one. Here's a Word document open on my computer of a statement of work we're sending out that somebody sent. If this document was shared to, say, Christy through our team site, she would be able to co-author the document. But again, for today's training, I just want to make sure people see how to sort of create and add and upload new documents. Across the top here, let me go back up real quick. I wanted to talk about some of the other things that you can do inside of the team that you've created. People want to upload videos sometimes of, say, I guess Adele and her Hello video, and there's some other good parodies going on right now that are really good if you guys haven't had a chance to find them. There's the ability to look at, you know, like a, oh, you can add OneNotes to this. So, you know, here's what's called a OneNote that we put in there with a server refresh planner we're going to do.
Can you pin actual files to the top, Sean?
Can you pin actual files to the top?
Yeah, like an Excel document instead of a OneNote.
Yeah, you can put any sort of Microsoft document or PDFs or other type of documents pinned to the top.
Awesome.
Yeah. Let me show you a little bit over here about some of the other things that within a team you can create. And we talked a little bit about this in previous sessions, but you know, let's just say, you know, my company wants to show different things, maybe motivation, and we do this, maybe motivational videos that somebody's put out on YouTube. I can add a YouTube piece to the top right there. It'll ask me quickly if I want to be able to embed a link from a YouTube video. I can put it there and it gets posted up at the top. I can do things such as, you know, add a PDF up top or even add a product like Microsoft Flow. And if you guys haven't seen what Microsoft Flow is, it's essentially a workflow management tool that automates things like taking Google Drive and putting it into Office 365 or Teams, or taking a Dropbox file that you have stored somewhere else and plunking it up in a Teams. So really unique product that just creates automated workflows for your organization.
So can you integrate Google or Gmail with Teams? Someone was asking that before.
For sure, but so the Gmail integration is more of a email integration of, let's for example say I want to send from a Gmail account or I want to send from my Outlook from a Gmail account out, you can do that. Or vice versa, if I want to have Gmail coming into Microsoft Teams as part of my activity, we can do that as well. If you looked at, go ahead.
Couple other questions. So this is, we have a question about the calendar aspect of Teams. So the question is, they can't figure out a way to share their calendar in Teams, assuming it's possible. Is this something we can do? And so the way I would understand it is, I would go into my Outlook, share my calendar with that person, and then when I'm creating a meeting in Teams, you can look at the scheduling assistant and it could show you, you know, once you add that person to the meeting, using that scheduling assistant. Do you want to show that, Sean, if you're in Teams?
In Teams? Okay, well, so.
Yeah, so if you go to Teams and you create a new meeting and say you add me as the other attendee, so type in me as the required attendee, and then you can go to the scheduling assistant at the top. And then this will show both mine and Sean's calendars. So, you know, because we're integrated on Outlook, this is how I would go about that question. I don't know if you have another idea.
No, and the other way to deal with that is, if you're just trying to get back to the old ways of sharing calendars, is over here, you could do a couple things, which is, one, share the calendar inside of Outlook with a shared feature, or publish it online. And of course, give somebody else permission to view your calendar.
Right.
But again, anything that's happening inside of Outlook, meaning if I'm creating an event or vice versa, doing it inside of Microsoft Teams, like you just saw, these two things sync up. I think we also showed, and again, I know some of this can be repetitive for everyone, but if we want to, which I think is a really cool thing that I use as an executive all the time, if I want to start my own meeting, I can title it up here, I can enable my video camera and join it. This video that I create, say for the company or say for a customer, automatically gets published inside of Microsoft Stream. So it's pretty cool how that works. But back to calendar, we talked a lot about how you can start, you know, Zoom meetings from here. You can create a new meeting from here. You know, you really name it. It can become a live event from here, which we talked a little bit about that last week. Meaning, if I want to have an event that's recorded, interaction from my employees or an outside audience, this is where a live meeting can happen, and it can start on the fly. So right inside of the calendar app.
Yeah, and those live events are starting to have some like webinar type capabilities. So once they get there, I'm excited to start utilizing that too.
Yep. And then, go ahead.
I was going to say, we had another question, unless you want to go through something a little bit more here.
No, go for it.
Okay, so this one's a little off topic, and I'd be interested to hear what your thoughts are, but they're asking, when they save to OneDrive, it takes quite a bit of a while, and so it dissuades them from using it. My guess would be something along possibly the file size, or there's maybe an issue with the syncing. Do you have any insight on maybe why that's happening for this person?
Yeah, so it depends on where you're saving it from. I don't want to give
it depends. Go down a rabbit hole on it,
but yeah, but it depends on where you're saving it from. What we do inside of OneDrive is, I have certain file shares or files folders from our old, what's called G Drive, mapped into OneDrive. So when I save a file to the old G Drive under clients, there's actually a clients folder we've mapped or synced, so to speak, to OneDrive, or we've synced it to quote unquote SharePoint or Teams. And I think as end user experiences change and people get adjusted to using platforms like this, I think getting things synchronized is a much easier way to save stuff versus trying to learn the new way. So it's important when people set this up that they understand how to map drives and synchronize platforms, files to either OneDrive, SharePoint, or ultimately Microsoft Teams. So I hope that helps. It really just depends. You know, we talked a little bit about Teams being a voice platform. You know, if calls come in here, you know, what were they for? Your voicemails come in here as well. We also talked a lot about files. And, you know, just like inside of your Outlook, when you go to attach a file, anything that we've done recent, so you just notice the stay safe ones up at the top, you're going to see what it's about, what team it exists in, and, of course, give you other options to, say, open it from here again inside of your desktop app for Word or your browser.
Sean, question about that workflow you kind of were just talking through. Do you use a separate account/machine to manage the mapped drive?
No, this is a synchronization feature. Let me see if I can show, let's go back up here let me do a few different things. Let me show you this. So let's just take OneDrive and I don't know, I'm in a group called Vistage. Basically if I want to be able to go in there and I want to be able to essentially synchronize something to this OneDrive folder, okay? You can come up to this and you're gonna notice right now this has actually already been synchronized to the cloud, but normally if I go in here, I can right click and I can sync. But again, because we've already done it, it's automatically synced to this folder from my Vistage on-premise or Vistage file share that I have.
Yeah, and the other thing is you could check your OneDrive sync settings too.
Synchronizing folders, it's the IT people who typically do it. And once it's done, it makes it easy for the user, but there is, I will say it, some challenges if you're not familiar with how to do it at first. I mean, you'll also notice that inside of some of these teams, when you go into these file shares, you're gonna see this ability to, I don't wanna go too far down the rabbit hole today on this one, but synchronizing this right here to connect into your OneDrive device. So if I wanna synchronize from OneDrive to my, you're gonna see it right now, general, it's gonna files from a particular file here. So in essence, to keep it really simple for today, if you think about it, if I had a file share inside of a G drive or an F drive and I synced it to my managed solution OneDrive, I could also sync it to my Teams or sync it directly to Teams. It's really up to you how you want to set up what we call the taxonomy for your organization. The last thing we talked about is using this left-hand side to be able to put other things in place, you know, their apps, so to speak. So if I want to create like my Zoom meetings from here, I can do that. If I want to create my, OneNote or WebEx apps, you know, I can start it over here as well. So we showed this last week, but, that it's just a nice integration with Teams. And the other one that's becoming big for us is we're seeing a lot of people who want to get Slack integrated with Teams so that they can use the Teams interface as sort of their chat function. But in this case, you know, maybe they want to use Slack for their document management. So anyway, just some ideas there. Cool. And then down the line, like I mentioned earlier, there is a whole ton of apps that you can integrate that you guys are probably using in your business that integrate right inside of, you know, Microsoft Teams, from, you know, calendar bots to, you know, Salesforce to, you know, Google Drive, really up to you how you use them. But there's hundreds and hundreds of these that can be integrated for better productivity. But again, all funneling outside of, or inside of Teams.
Yeah, and they're always adding new ones, especially now with everything that's going on. They realize the importance of these integrations. So
yeah. GitHub for developers, it's pretty unique.
And there's no more questions, so. I know we could sit here and talk all day about this because we love it, but we will see you guys next Wednesday. Again, we're going to keep talking about Teams because that seems what you guys are looking to learn about. But if you have questions or anything else, just respond to the email I'm going to send out with the recording and we'll make sure that we get an answer for you. So we'll see you next week. And until then, stay healthy.
Thanks, everyone.
Bye-bye.